Make sure you guys smash that subscribe button if you guys are fans of the content being posted onto this channel to always be in the loop with more content similar to this, and be sure to hit the video up with a like if you're enjoying the content. And with that being said, let's begin. So Resident Evil Village opened up many doors, especially with its overall ending and seeing how Ethan Winters had been killed and for his daughter Rose to live on. There have been so many people within the Resident Evil community and within the horror community theorizing, speculating, and kind of wondering as to what kind of direction Capcom is going to seemingly go in having to take Rose's story further, and possibly even including the elements of the BSAA, as we've seen towards the end with Chris Redfield finding out that basically the BSAA organization that Chris helped founded is doing some behind the scenes sneaky stuff that really went on to prompt Chris in going out to Europe to the BSAA headquarters and finding out and getting to the bottom of this. So joining me here today to further discuss the concept of Resident Evil 9 is my good friend and YouTuber Mark and I. Now Mark, there are so many elements I think that are going to be included in this story to where there is no doubt that Capcom is looking to basically close off this trilogy involving the Winters family, of course seeing the events transpire from Resident Evil 7 into Resident Evil Village, and assumingly going to follow up in Resident Evil 9. My question to you is, do you think this is going to involve Rose and kind of jumping forward in some sort of a weird time skip? Because at the very end of Resident Evil Village, we get to see how Rose is now assumingly either a late teen or early adult. She's grown a lot since, of course, her father having to sacrifice himself in saving both her and Chris. So now we know that she is going to be assumingly the ultimate BOW. She is made up of the metamyceid and of course the mold itself from her parents, of course Mia and Ethan. So my question to you is, being the fact that right now Rose is a BOW after telling the agent at the end of Resident Evil Village that she possesses and can do things that not even Chris is aware of, do you think that perhaps now this is going to be the end of the Winters family story in them having to go out into Europe and find out what's going on in this BSAA headquarters facility in getting down to the bottom of the nitty-gritty? Or do you think that perhaps maybe Resident Evil 9 isn't going to have anything to do with Chris or Rose, but instead it's going to do its own thing? Because I think they really can't leave us on this cliffhanger to suggest that Rose is this incredibly powerful and almost seemingly indestructible kind of BOW weapon that ironically is working for the good guys here. So do you see this to where the Resident Evil 9 story is going to pick up after Village and kind of jump forward in a time skip? I do believe that perhaps maybe it's not going to be the case in point where Rose is just 15 years older, 20 years older, perhaps maybe because she had been reborn in the game and she possesses these abilities and all of these weird skill sets. Maybe perhaps she has the ability to age rapidly, so maybe perhaps it has been simply 3 or 4 years, and instead of aging 3 or 4 years, Rose aged 15, 20 years. So my question is, what do you see Resident Evil 9 doing, and is this going to be the definitive end of perhaps maybe the Winters family storyline, or maybe even Chris? Because there is so much that I think you can do with this, and there is so much more for, I think, Capcom to explore, that it is without a doubt going to be interesting in seeing what the direction is going to be, and to kind of gain a better understanding as to what they can do involving Rose if she is that powerful. So I want to get your take as to where this could go and how this could possibly end.
The revelation that Spencer was a part of all of this, and that everything that Umbrella has ever done has been in relation to Miranda, has been in relation to the mold, and the mega mycete, like that was cool, that was interesting, I liked that. But I also thought that if that's how they want to take it, then that means that theoretically at the end of Resident Evil 9, whatever happens, like, that's the end of it all, right? Like, I don't know what else that you could do. Like, I love the zombies. I love the different variations that we've dealt with. The Ouroboros, Las Plagas, like, all that stuff is very interesting. I like that all. But every single game all stems from experiments Umbrella was doing and people who worked for them that are trying to sell those experiments to different parts of the world or take over the world or whatever. And it all has to do with Miranda and her mold. If Miranda is dead and her mold is destroyed, which, I mean, it makes sense that Ethan was a part of that. And if Ethan is now dead, I don't understand exactly how Rose is exactly alive, sort of. I don't get how she's still kind of like doing her own thing. I'm still kind of concerned by that. But if she's alive, whatever, if she's able to live on her own and do her own thing, and Ethan is gone, as we know, by the end, I really don't know what direction they're planning with this. Because in that sort of after credit scene where you see Rose and she's older, like you said, I mean, Rose is a little baby, sort of reborn anyway, right? Like, as far as we know, at the end of Resident Evil 8, like, Rose is minutes old, basically, after being reborn. Then that means that the version that we saw, I think she was in her late teens, maybe early 20s at like the most reasonable time period. Then obviously Chris and everybody is so much older, and there's other things that are happening here, but she seems to be at peace. The world seems to be at peace. She's stopping off at like this cemetery, and I'm like, I don't know what the world is like. Clearly the world is not overrun by viruses or creatures or beings or whatever, but I'm like, if Ethan got killed because Miranda was taken out, like, doesn't that mean that every other sort of being or experiment also died in the process? Like, I don't really get all that. I don't know what they want to do. Like, I have no idea what sort of obstacle Rose is going to hold in her own story, other than being a bioweapon that other people want to take advantage of. Because Spencer is dead. Umbrella's destroyed. You have Blue Umbrella now. Chris is way too old. Like, the special agent that was looking over Rose is clearly talking to someone, but we don't know exactly who, but they're watching Rose. And he mentions, after Rose's little act of aggression, which was very clearly messing with the agent because he was being a jerk, but he says, you know, like, stand down, even though they have a clear shot, which means they're close enough to put one in her head, which means they're probably tailing that car for backup, knowing that she is very dangerous and powerful, even though she sort of seems like a good guy. You know, and if we do play as her, like, obviously she's going to be the protagonist of the next game, but I don't know who the enemy would be. Everybody's dead. Like, Wesker has died since, you know, a ways back. Spencer has been dead since a ways back. Umbrella is no longer present. Like, I don't know who the enemy would be. And the village kind of seemed like the introduction of it all, of where it all came from. And now that's all gone too in one game. We were introduced to the source, and the source was destroyed all in one gaming experience. So I can't answer it. I don't know. I am so at a loss with how it's going to take place in the future that I really can't seem to fathom what they want to do with it, because it seems like whatever they're going to do is going to be the end of the Resident Evil franchise. I don't know where they go from there.
I actually think there's a lot that you can do, and I think that the end of Resident Evil Village kind of points us in that direction with the BSAA, and I think that whatever happened with Umbrella, that's over and done with. We're no longer going to be dabbling back into the, you know, the origins of Spencer and Wesker and all that stuff. It's been done to death. But my question to you is, what about Rose in terms of using her and kind of getting a better perspective in playing as her and playing as the allied BOW to find out what's going on here? Because I'm still under the impression that right now, it is highly possible that if they don't want to go on ahead and do a massive time skip 10, 15, 20 years later, because let's be frank, Chris and Ada and Jill and Leon, they're all going to be really old, so you don't really want to play as, you know, individuals that are in their late 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and you're going about this narrative where you have to fight these monsters and whatnot. I mean, it's not realistic, so I can definitely see it to where she probably has age acceleration. But in terms of that, do you see this all culminating with Chris's narrative of going to Europe and getting down to the bottom of this? And even if Rose is supposed to be the embodiment of what Miranda wanted and the embodiment of power, which again Miranda did fear, then it's only safe to assume that they're going to end this off with either Rose surviving and Chris dying, or perhaps maybe Rose dying and Chris surviving. And we know that Capcom is going to continue to make Resident Evil games. They're going to move away from the moniker of Resident Evil 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and they're going to be doing other things after Resident Evil Village. So my question to you is, what about Rose's narrative? What about Chris's narrative? Because Chris at the very end saw that, you know, one of his soldiers pointed out that the BSAA was not just sending in soldiers, they were kind of sending in BOWs, right? So we can kind of have this battle of clones, right? We have the embodiment of Rose, who is a BOW, versus other BOW clones. So what is your overall take and perspective on the idea of Rose and for this to be the end of the Winters storyline?
Okay, so you brought up a good point, like a handful of good points that I didn't even think about. So this, again, this just proves that my mental capacity is very weak, and I didn't even think about that. That makes 100% perfect sense. This could have been literally like 2 weeks later and she could have aged completely. I didn't even go there, and I think that probably makes the most sense, because I feel like the Resident Evil franchise is, it, I mean, the monsters and the villains, the antagonists are just as iconic in this series as are the protagonists. Like the bad guys and the good guys, they're just as equally interesting across the board. So I don't think it would be smart from a marketing standpoint. Again, this is just me as a fan, like to completely like redo Resident Evil from the ground up without like involving Umbrella and just like doing different characters. Now, obviously there are brilliant people out there that could definitely make that work, could totally impress me, and I would love it. But I mean, if you were to tell me that the future of Resident Evil involves never again seeing Chris Redfield, never again seeing Leon Scott Kennedy, if you were telling me that was going to be the case, I'm probably going to be more disappointed than I am open to the idea of an unknown, mysterious future as a fan. Now, that said, I mean, the idea that Rose ages more quickly as a BOW, that makes perfect sense, and I'm totally okay with that. You said that they knew that where they were going with 10-11, so we are getting like more games. I'm very happy to hear that, because I wasn't aware of that, so that's definitely good news. But I do wonder though, if you remove the Umbrella element completely, like, is it gonna feel the same? Maybe it could. I think the BSAA aspect, that was probably one of the most interesting plot points to me, since we sort of figured out that Umbrella and Spencer and Miranda were all sort of intertwined. Like Spencer ventured the world, he was looking for something, he was like basically trying to find a way to like make people immortal, and then he wanted to create gods and like take over the planet and reach the new level of like human evolution, and the mold was the way to do that. And Miranda, I guess, was just thinking too small time, but still worked with him on it. I was like, okay, that's pretty cool, that I like how they connected all that together. But then like bringing in the idea that, okay, like here's an organization that Chris was a co-founder of that was supposed to be for good. Now they're using like BOWs. Like, is this because they just don't want to have normal humans out there like risking their lives? And it just makes more sense to have things that are sort of already dead or were never alive to begin with. Like that, I mean, that would be curious to see how that goes. And again, I think like my concern goes away completely when we look at it the way that you said, by being like, okay, Rose just ages faster than everybody else, because I don't want to live in a world where my Resident Evil future does not consist of some of my favorite Resident Evil characters. Like I miss Leon, I will miss Chris, I will miss Jill and Ada Wong, like all these people, like, you know, but if it's not too far in the future, I don't know what other threat is going on in the world. But it does stand to reason, thinking about it now, that this, the mold, the Megamycete, and like all the stuff that goes along with that, like it does stand to reason that it could exist in other parts of the world. It could stand to reason that there are other supernatural elements out there that can push the next phases of human evolution to its limits. Like it's totally possible the Megamycete might not be the only thing that's out there. And think about it, like this mold like creates things sort of at random based on like the host. Think of the random grab bag of powers and abilities and monsters and villains that this thing created. It created werewolves, it created vampires, it created a guy who can control magnetic fields, it created illusions, it created people who can control puppets, it created these gigantic sea monsters. Like it's literally everything, like literally everything. So I mean, there's definite possibilities, but I just don't know if we have seen anything yet in the games thus far that sort of hint at the direction they want to go with it. Outside of Rose is alive, she's got this visible age to her, whether or not she's that old in years or that's just how she's aged, whatever, it's one or the other. Again, I'm glad that you said that, because that kind of put me at ease. I don't have a guess, but I do think you're onto something. I'd be curious some more what your thoughts are on that, actually.
I'm definitely under the impression that this entire thing is going to basically end off with the BSAA. It only makes sense because you have to consider a few things. As an example, you have to kind of close out that story, and being the fact that Chris was one of the founders of the BSAA organization, it's only fair to kind of go in there to find out what's happening, and for Rose to either get closure or for her to be written off for good. And I can't wait to see how this is all basically going to unfold, because we're probably not going to get RE9 for a very long time, because up next is the RE4 remake and then possibly other games after that. So in the comment section below, we want to get your thoughts on Rose. We want to get your thoughts on the whole BSAA narrative and what you guys believe is going to happen moving forward as we near and go into Resident Evil 9. So again, thank you all so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed and cannot wait to see more and are simply fans of Resident Evil, then be sure to give this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below. Hit that subscribe button if you guys are new. Also, be sure to check out Mark9's channel. I will leave his link located down below. Mark, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you all so much for watching. We have a lot to look forward to, and I think that the future is bright, but we're gonna have to wait and see what happens. So again, thank you all once more, and we'll be seeing you all down the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace.